About a decade ago, I was asked to develop for the doctoral students in public health a course that would show them the original documents for the things that have happened in public health that are key, that have made real changes in the way we do public health over time. That effort was so great that it really needed to be turned into a book. Having students continue to do these readings without having it in one place and having it in multiple formats and everybody Xeroxing a copy, and it was just awful. So I started with Hippocrates and moved forward. The first volume of this, what is going to be a two-volume set, really only goes as far as 1900. And then I've moved now to dealing with the things that have happened in the 20th century. The two volumes then really will be the capstone of the historical research that I've done on the development of public health over time. Volume one is different in that each chapter is set up with an individual who made a breakthrough. And you can tell the story of their life and why they were interesting. One of the things I learned from volume one is how important the printing press was in being able to distribute information. And what I take for granted now, I can pull up PubMed on my computer and I can find all sorts of references very quickly. That didn't exist before 1960. We didn't even have Index Medicus. Citation changes in the literature over time. So that Hippocrates is telling you about what travelers who went to China said about disease in China. In the 16, 17, 1800s, it's what the letters of Dr. So-and-so or the memoirs say. And you don't have published medical literature to cite, you know, the JAMA, volume 54. That doesn't happen until mid-20th century. So that citations like we do now, we take for granted, and it didn't exist. The ability to search didn't exist. So I'm finding that very exciting, because that's a learning of how scholarship has changed over time. What happens after the beginning of the 20th century is that science just explodes. The development of synthetic vitamins and understanding the importance of nutrition and trace elements happens in those first 20 years of the 20th century. The impact of the stock market crash and the Great Depression on health and nutrition is so severe that you have an entire generation that were exposed to diseases such as rickets. The Wonder Bread of when I grew up, that is the introduction of vitamin fortification into flour. That happens during World War II because the cohort of men to fight born during the Great Depression were seriously malnourished between the rickets and the loss of teeth from scurvy and other nutritional diseases. Many men were 4F and never did enter the army. So with the stroke of a pen, the first executive order of Franklin Roosevelt was to enrich flour for the armed services. And today we all eat enriched flour and we think nothing of it. What we learned from having the students read the original materials and then discussing them amongst ourselves was how important those things really are and how we've forgotten how important those things are.